a beloved IP that just happens to be the biggest entertainment property in the world, Star Wars is in a fascinating place. With the latest string of films having spectacular highs and lows, and The Mandalorian on Disney Plus reclaiming a lot of the negativity surrounding the brand after Rise of Skywalker, it's worth taking a step back to analyze just how we got here. Because I don't know about you, but coming out of The Last Jedi, regardless of whether you were a fan or not, it felt like the core mechanics of the franchise were forever changed, altered to include a level of nuance and contemplation no other installment had gone anywhere near. To adequately break down what I'd say is the most pivotal scene in Star Wars history, let's quickly go back to the beginning. Star Wars used to be so simple. Light, dark, rebels, the Empire, all such easy access, thematic and characterful elements that were enjoyable to get on board with and fun to watch play out. Couple these universal, time-tested themes with an audience of 1997, a time when such a feat in cinema hadn't been achieved. And with a stellar marketing campaign only teasing what George Lucas had accomplished, you had to see it to believe. One of the most memorable parts of the entire Star Wars saga is Luke's redemption of Darth Vader. Go back, watch it now, and it almost doesn't make sense. Luke starts sensing that there's good in Vader despite his last interaction being the one where he lost a limb. And before you know it, young Skywalker is determined to save his father no matter what. Why? Because there's good in him. I know it. As has been established over the years, this was not the plan from the beginning. It's evident in everything from Mark Hamill filming Empire's reveal scene under the knowledge that Obi-Wan killed your father, and in some hilariously terrible dialogue from Alec Guinness. Obi-Wan had to pretend that Darth Vader killing Luke's father was a turn of phrase, as he became Darth over time. Regardless, whether we knew it or not, this was the fundamental touchstone of grey between the light and the dark. The exploration of redemption and forgiveness that elevated the entire Star Wars brand above otherwise simplistic ideals of good and bad. Vader's final turn towards the light, however clumsily handled overall despite our collective love for it, is a very human moment, and again something that only enhanced the story being told. Clearly, this idea of subversion enhancing a body of work was something Rian Johnson wanted to explore in The Last Jedi. His installment is bold, unique, challenging, and makes a point of assembling personal obstacles for each character to overcome. With this almost mission-like approach to subverting expectations, though, it resulted in a notably divided fanbase. However, the method is not unlike George Lucas's actions with the close of Empire and Return. The Last Jedi took the idea of introducing an entirely alien element to the canon and then ran with it. Rey's parents are nobody, Snoke is disposable, Kylo doesn't need to follow in his grandfather's footsteps, Poe's confidence can blur into arrogance. All these factors or realizations come out of nowhere and yet we're asked to grapple with them. Luke says Vader is good, Kylo says Rey's parents don't matter, Luke almost killed teenage Kylo while he was sleeping. These are all major narrative swerves, but what is the movie and the franchise going to do with them? Onto the scene that I think broke Star Wars, or at least changed it forever, the Join Me scene. The scene that exemplifies the past, present, and future of Star Wars in one gesture, and the scene behind the purpose of this video, is Kylo extending the hand of partnership to Rey. Following the pair of them decimating Snoke and the Praetorian Guards together, Kylo offers Rey a truce. Join with him and rule the galaxy together. Obviously, we have a clash in core ideals. The very idea of galaxy-wide rulership invokes dictatorships and tyranny from Kylo, versus whichever sense of governance, equity, and rulemaking Rey and the Rebels would be comfortable with. Regardless, the point stands. This was Star Wars venturing so much further into grey subject matter, the mixing of two ideologies with semblances of Vader-like redemption and forgiveness, than ever before. All the subversion, all the narrative rug pulls, and the strange feel to Rian Johnson's script, all built to this moment. The combination of Luke's "the Jedi need to end" mentality twinned with a depth of scriptwriting that would see Star Wars into a whole new realm of nuanced thematic potential, it could have been the birth of a whole new dimension to what Star Wars represents. Sadly, at this pivotal moment, and likely because the film needed to end in a way for another director to pick up the baton, Rian Johnson pulled back. Rey rejects this middle ground entirely. She wants to fight. She metatextually needs to maintain the brand, the endless war of light versus dark that is Star Wars. There is no middle ground or room for true progression on a human level. Star Wars needs heroes, villains, and easy access motivations. Light, dark, good, bad, now and forever. Johnson took us to the edge of where this fiction can go, then walked us back, almost throwing a middle finger to the background business interests that govern a blockbuster Disney trilogy along the way. The Last Jedi is one hell of a thing, but it still closes out by resetting the playing field for an infinite future of sequels and spin-offs. Once that Force ghost was out the bottle though, it can't go back in. Let's talk about Rise of Skywalker. Any sole creative decision can't be respected by a larger corporate entity. Not when it relates to the fundamentals of a brand in such a way as The Last Jedi does Star Wars. The only person who could continue the themes explored in that scene between Kylo and Rey was Rian Johnson. But by sheer fact of how unplanned the sequel trilogy was, Johnson's mandate was one and done, leaving scores of narrative threads for someone with equal confidence to tackle. The problem then? Well, after Johnson wrote a much less nuanced good versus bad finale, Disney too buckled under the pressure. Rather than trust in what Johnson set in motion, perhaps getting him to write another installment and prove all the naysayers wrong, they did what all large corporations do when faced with an angry mob of fans: they went on the defensive. J.J. Abrams was drafted in, Palpatine was resurrected, Rey was given parentage. Poe got lots more to do, Luke came back as a Force ghost, and oh look, an X-Wing being lifted out of some water. Rise of Skywalker coldly and systematically repaired the Star Wars brand in front of our eyes, and the process was hideous. It was insulting to everything Rian Johnson put together, and insulting to the fans for genuinely caring about what was unfolding beforehand. With creativity by committee and corporately mandated box-ticking plot points, this theme park ride of a film might have given fast food sugar highs, but there's nothing here that satisfies long term. Disney let someone take the reins who didn't have corporate longevity at heart, planting a storytelling seed that very few auteurs will ever be able to effectively weaponize. Modern Star Wars has a ruptured hull because we've seen its limitations. To not honor the potential of what could be is fundamentally lackluster, fundamentally backwards or neutral, and fundamentally just that little bit boring. I'm sure expanded universe slash Star Wars legend stories will continue being the most fascinating and progressive tales possible, but for the cinematic side of things, on the scale of mass marketed Hollywood blockbusters, they have an unquantifiably steep mountain to climb. Even worse, millions of us need to be convinced to even watch them try. Disney's plan is to travel 200 years into the past for a whole new setting, before all the quote-unquote mistakes of the last few real-world years, to reset the playing field even more drastically, restoring clearer-cut notions of good and bad across the galaxy. Will that satisfy? Can Star Wars ever be more than it was? Well, clearly the IP needs to find a whole new way to exist, because the past has died whether we wanted it to or not, and no amount of digital face recreation can ever change that. At least that's where I'm at with Star Wars. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Where did you sit on the likes of the Mandalorian Season 2's finale? Did you jump for joy and were you just psyched to see that particular character come back? Or did some part of you yearn for some sort of progressive material that would carry Star Wars forward with a more overt purpose? For now, I've been Scott from WhatCulture.com. Thank you very much for listening, and I'll catch you soon.